Soul contract, life between lives. The law of cause and effect, what we call karma, definitely takes effect in the bardo or life between lives. The Arab Muslim term for the Hindu Buddhist term, bardo, is almost similar. Muslims know this realm as the Barzakh. Hello everyone. I'm going to explain what I've encountered in the life between lives realm. I have astral travel encounters and I have visited this life between realm often. I don't know everything and I am a seeker of truth. I'm a journalist and author from Cape Town, South Africa. I'm new to YouTube and hardly a month active here. My channel has steadily grown. I'm posting informative video clips on the esoteric phenomena and the paranormal. I speak from first-hand experience and beyond the ordinary feat. I am posting my videos so that other people can learn from my own supernatural encounters. There is a link at the bottom of my esoteric books which you can read free online. Or you can buy at only $1. I am homeless currently due to the worldwide lockdown. I would appreciate you buy a book, the advertised health product, or you can donate small change via PayPal. Let us get right into it now. Relax and enjoy the video clip. The first time I had an astral projection encounter was during my first year at a local Cape Town university. I thought I had died. I saw my physical body on the bed with its eyes wide open. I found myself floating in the air in my room. I had just slipped out of my body, because I must have died, I thought. I saw bright light all around me. The light was coming from me, from my own soul. I felt extremely peaceful. I remember thinking, it is all right to be dead. I realized all my poverty-stricken problems in the world and my suffering did not matter any longer. In fact, nothing in the world where I lived mattered any longer. Since I was now dead, I remember thinking, wasn't there supposed to be angels and deceased relatives and friends? Or any spirit guides? Nada. Nothing, no one. Suddenly, I could hear a voice inside my head telling me I'm not dead and to allow myself to come to him. It was my main spirit guide, it was the soul of a Sufi saint who had died in 1713. I found myself standing in front of this saintly soul figure inside his shrine. He initiated me into the higher spirit realm, and said the order came from above. Since then I have frequent astral projections and travels. Now, let's talk about the bardo, Barzakh, or the stage and realm of life between lives. A lot of esoterically minded people outrightly say, yes, there is no hell, there is no punishment. Yet they feel there is a heaven. I did not see this as the way a lot of people believe. In fact, I saw there were places of joy as well as of agony. I saw people who are good people roam free and mostly are adorned in white robes. I have seen evil people are not happy in the life between lives. I saw evil people were confined in different groupings. Although your soul contract is based on mercy, quite the contrary, evil people are confined inside dark solitary dungeons wearing no clothes. It is as if they are being disgraced. I astrally visited friends and people I have known while they were alive. I found at least two of them confined in a solitary dungeon. I also saw your state in the afterlife is based on the way you lived while alive on earth. If you prevented people and even animals from drinking water, you will have no water and you will remain thirsty for a very long period, for example. On the bright side, I found those people can be released through spiritual intervention and invocation and prayer. I saw the souls of the departed live inside houses, they eat, sleep, have a partner and even study. Many on the other side become helpers and spirit guides and they grow through the person they guide. I saw there are many levels in what is known as the astral plane. The astral plane is an almost exact replica of the physical world. Your next soul contract is being developed while in the stage of life between lives. When you have harmed someone while alive, you will experience regret and even take on similar pain you had inflicted on others. You then readily agree to undergo similar punishment or your soul contract would determine you recompensate that person. I stress again, this soul contract we have is based on divine mercy, of a God who does not really want to punish us. Until next time.